So hello all, today we have Dr. S.N. Venkatesh from Seshadripuram First Grade College on our platform, and we'd like to thank you, sir, for giving us the opportunity to interview you and listen your thoughts on education, and I'm sure this will be a great help for the aspirants of the college. So I'd like to begin with the interview. So the first question for you, sir, would be, being the principal of Seshadripuram First Grade College, what is your philosophy of leadership? How would you describe your leadership style?
See, as in principal of Seshadripuram First Grade College, as an administrator, we have two important roles to play. One as an administrator, another as an academic. If you don't play both the roles as a principal, I think your role as a principal become useless. First, you have to give more prioritize for your academic, especially for the teaching fraternity are concerned. You have to see that the student should get the good amount of quality of teaching. That is the first priority for me. Second priority, you should have a good administration. See, without good administration, just the teacher teaches in the classroom, I think you have the college will not run. So the both the administration, academic play a dominant role for a principal. And as a principal, I think that my role is an agent, because I had to connectivity with the teachers, with the students, with the management, with the university, with the government.
Absolutely.
So take all of them into account. See that everything should be in a standardized and normal form, so that in a correct line, so that we can administer and make the college one of the best college. So for developing the college, for making the college as a good college, I think involvement of the teachers, involvement of the parents, involvement of the students, involvement of the university, involvement of the government and public, all are very important. They're all stakeholders of the institution. If all together go in the same direction, then we can build the institution to the greater heights.
That's amazing, sir. So I'll just move on to the next question. So the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently, right? So in your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute?
See, what I feel today is that in India, the education system is a classroom-based system. We given more emphasis on the textual-based system. If you take an example, even our examination is based on the textual things rather than practical oriented. See, I can look into the Oklahoma University, or Southern Oklahoma University of US, New York University, and even if you go to the Grimsby Institute of UK, because we have a tie-up with that institute. Normally, their syllabus, their pattern of teaching and their pattern of learning process are totally different from Indian system. So in India, we given more emphasis only on the textual things, and we think that if a student is perfect in the textual thing, he will be the rank student. But in foreign country, the education system was so different, they given more emphasis on the practical oriented items. And practicality is a very important in the foreign country. Second, very important, what I've seen, that the foreign education system with Indian education system, we given more important for the age preference. That is a very, very bad in Indian system. See, what happened, if a student passed second PUC, an immediate successive next year, you want to join the degree course. Immediate after completion of degree, we want to join him for the post-graduation course. See, that makes him a compulsion on the studies. But in foreign countries, it's not so. I observed, see, the person with after 30 years, the 45 years, he come for a college education. What it means, the students who are voluntary, go for higher education, they are preferred for higher education, they are encouraged for the higher education. Here, some forcibility, either from the parents or from the teachers or from the society is there. That is a lot of difference. So this textual things should remove and be given more emphasis on the practical aspects. At the same time, we should involve more voluntary contribution, voluntary things in the higher education.
Right, right, sir. I absolutely agree with you on that. So the next question for you would be, how does the curriculum of Seshadripuram First Grade College ensure the best practice of industry?
See, madam, normally two things I as a principal I believe. One, as a student, when it is a learning process, a student should be research oriented. Number two, I always believe in industrial integrated programs. Normally in our Seshadripuram first grade college Yelahanka, we believe both. See, I encourage the student to go for the research in a two or three ways. One, we encourage the student for the poster presentation. Whatever the topics they like, let them present the paper on the posters. Number two, we encourage the student to present the papers in the international national seminars. And in the own, in Seshadripuram inside, the we have one important competition that is called Excellent Researcher Competition, where the student can come out with some research. We will award them a prize. See, first thing, I want to make the student more research-oriented. That will play a dominant role, important role, significant role when he go for the corporate world, when he go for the placements, when he go for the, his own entrepreneurship. When he face the society, play a dominant role when he become a researcher. Second, very importantly, we have an industrial tie-up program, integrated program. Last year, Tata Consultancy Service has an integrated program with the, they train the student, they board the student. And even Fidelity, we have a training from the Fidelity. So many corporates, we have a training program in our college. So IBM, we have a training program. So that way, we make them to encourage to learn what they're in the corporate, learn the training programs from them, and let them have a good opportunity once they finish their undergraduate program.
So I'd also like to ask you, right? So any insights into how your university could be more welcoming to students of different races or economic backgrounds?
See, normally university supports us a lot because since we are an affiliated college, we are bound to obey the rules and regulation of the Bangalore City University, and it is performing well. And normally what happened for an economic poorer students, they're given a lot of opportunities, especially those who are come from the rural areas, those who belongs to scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward classes, they are given a lot of preferences. In the social welfare department, they are given 50% of the fees of the our scheduled caste, scheduled tribe students, about OBC students, about 30% of the fees they are going to reimburse. So a lot of encouragement was given by the university. Even they are going to be exempted from the examination fees, even in the undergraduate course, from the PGCET quota, from MCOM and MCOM, if we are at a free of cost, we are providing. At the same time, happy to say that my management supports a lot for me, especially for the economically weaker section. I'm a meritorious student. Above 95%, those students who joined our institution, we given a free of cost of education. Absolutely free. We are not charging even single pie. And for those who scored between 90 to 95%, about 10,000 scholarship has been provided by our trust. You believe it or not, last academic year from the trust, we have got 15 lakhs scholarship for the different economically backward, poorer section of the student and economically weaker section of the student. From government, we get about 50 lakhs scholarship. That is the major tune for it. At the same time, in my college also, when you come to the academics, I given more preference for the slow learners, as it is also a part of university rule. And we have to conduct some of the remedial classes, some of the slow learner classes for the slow learners. Normally, these slow learners, what we observed, either they're slow learners because of their background in the primary education, secondary education, or with their residential, some of the personal problems. So by this, by conducting these classes, we'll encourage them to improve their standards and make them to get good marks in their examination.
Okay, that's amazing, sir. So moving forward, I'd like to ask, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the college and the students are?
Madam, one point I make it very clear. If you ask my roles and responsibilities, I think I already told you, we are the, as a principal, it is a job of an agent. So I have to take all of them into account. See, I always believe in a democratic leadership. I am not an autocratic leadership. I want to make everyone should develop. Okay. I want to give the responsibility to all the faculty members in a different areas. Ultimately, I'm going to control everyone. Mm-hmm. But when you have a democratic leadership, you can achieve anything. Because in a college, I always believe it is a teamwork, it is not an individual work. It is a team decision, not an individual decision. So each and every person will become responsible for doing his work. So I delegate my authority to different levels at different perspective level for getting different work done. And we are doing best because in the Bangalore City University, this time, in spite of the COVID, our admission for the first year is more than 1,000. Okay. And we have students from ICCR, from foreign countries. We have a good number of students. These are all the good achievement what we did in our college. We were also accredited NAC A grade.
That's amazing, sir.
And 21 faculties are doing the PhD. Already out of 70 faculty, we have about 14 faculties complete their doctoral program.
Great.
From the last 5 years.
Okay, that's really amazing, sir. So moving ahead to the next question, what would you like people to know about your college that they may not know of?
I think one important thing in my college, the uniqueness of my college is we given value-based education, ma'am. No doubt. Education we are providing, and education is important for all the students, but value-based education is more important. Our Honorary General Secretary has clearly instructed, our management has clearly instructed us to start 3 important centers in our college. One is Gandhi Study Center, another is Vivekananda Study Center, another is Ambedkar Center. See, these 3 centers, normally they perform so many programs, invite so many things. Normally, the student change their attitude and change their behavior that I observe from the students. Mm-hmm. See, normally, this is the very important, because this is a uniqueness of our Seshadripuram College that I want to inform everyone. And our play, the no doubt, we are good in placement, we are good in academics, we are good in results, we are good in all the aspects. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, this is a uniqueness that value-based education is one of the important thing that we are going to provide to our students. That is very much required for the current generation.
Right, sir. So, what do you see as Seshadripuram First Grade College's greatest strengths?
You see, my greatest strength is my excellent faculty and a good number, the faith of parents on the institution. What 1,000 strength we have today, we have made a survey with the one survey was done by our students and teachers. That survey very clearly indicates that out of 1,000 admission for the academic year of 2020-21 we made, in spite of the COVID period, all 1,000, about 800 to 822 students were joined with the reference either from their brothers or sisters or from previous batchmates. That means it very clearly indicates that my strength is my alumnus. My strength is the current students. Right. That is the strength of Seshadripuram First Grade College along with excellent faculty members.
Right, so any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Ma'am, any message? My message for the youth is that please have a good academic record with value-based education, have a national integration that is very important for today's, and also have a socially productive citizens of this country. That is very important. That is very much required for the country.
Right, sir. So I'll just move on with the last question for you. So how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your institute?
I already told you that I always believed in democratic leadership. Yes. First point. And this is a teamwork. Mm-hmm. See, without having a healthy relation with the current people, you can't expect to work from them. Mm-hmm. And point number 3, very importantly, is that my way of administration is totally different from others. Mm-hmm. See, normally what I did, even if the small good work was done by any of the faculty member, we start appreciating them. Once you start appreciating the small work, definitely you can expect a good work from them. No doubt, all the faculties are not the same. They have about 75 teaching faculty, about 45 non-teaching faculty. It comes to 110 members in our college. But the thing is that when you start appreciating the small things, definitely they go for the good things. At the same time, if the employees did some wrong, it is common in all the college, in all the institution, we cannot say all the employees are 100% right. But you have to, if anything wrong goes wrong with any employees, you should ask the employees, we should sit them, we should see they are going to do it perfectly. And moreover, one point I will tell you why this happened, because I had a good support from my management. Mm-hmm. We have excellent management. Whatever the academic decision we are taken, they are support to us. Mm-hmm. Whatever the things we are going to take, they are support to us. Mm-hmm. See, the entire Bangalore, almost all colleges, they pay 50% salary during the COVID crisis. But only the college in the entire city, they are paying 100% salary during the COVID period. And they are supportive to us because of the great support from the management. I can able to make this as one of the best college.
That's amazing, sir. So thank you. I'd like to thank you again for the opportunity you gave us. And I'm sure your words will and your views is definitely going to help the aspiring students. And yes, sir.